Yes. All right. We have with us tonight guests from the Skunk Works. We've got Commander Katie Byrne, Commander Seraph, and Commander Soldier Sailor. Right off the bat, I want to say we've got links in the show notes to the YouTube page for Commander Katie Byrne and Commander Seraph, also the Twitch page for Commander Soldier Sailor, and several other links to various videos and things that I found to be personally very, very interesting. So let's start with first Commander Katie Burns. Katie, say hello to the beautiful people and tell us a little bit about the Skunk Works.
Sure. First of all, it's lovely to be here. My name is Commander Katie Byrne. I was formerly a director at the AXI and hold the number one position on the AXI's ace leaderboard. Eventually, though, my time with staff there, it just came to a point where we were running a separate server for wing events. And being a staff member at AXI is a lot of work. Nothing but the highest level of respect for the staff members there. There's a lot that goes on behind the scenes to make all of that work properly. And me and Seraph, we just decided that we would rather focus some time on the wing event side of things. So I left the staff at AXI to focus on Skunk Works, and it grew into a kind of counterpart to the AXI, where the AXI is where pilots go to learn AX, and they are second to none at teaching people how to fight Thargoids. And then Skunk Works is kind of like the kind of graduation group, the kind of where the masters go to carry out the highest level of AX following
That's beautiful. So
that.
just to clarify again, and I mean you just said it, but I just want to put it into very, very simple words for Americans. You're still part of AXI. It's just a situation of like the intro level and the beginners go to AXI and learn. And as we just said in the intro, 10,000 members celebrated this week. Like, that is amazing stuff and a huge salute to them. But as people progress and get to the point where they're ready for sort of the master class or what have you, they can move into different areas, and Skunk Works is definitely one of those. So you're still part of the AX community and very much affiliated with the AXI, but you're sort of the super, super advanced class.
Yeah, we're not officially recognized as part of the AXI as an organization. I'm retired from staff there, but Seraph, for example, is still a mentor at the AXI, an official mentor, as well as 40% of the AXI's ace list are now members of Skunk Works as well. So there are very close ties, even though whereas once we were essentially a wing server for the AXI. In order to give Skunk Works the time it needs properly, because again, like the AXI, where the staff there have a lot to do behind the scenes to keep it running, Skunk Works is just the same, where we have so much to get done in the week ahead of events coming up, and to make sure that people's ranks, much like the AXI, people's ranks are up to date. It is yeah, there are very close relationships between the two groups for sure.
That's
And also,
beautiful.
yeah, I would also like to congratulate the AXI on reaching 10,000 members. That is it's an incredible achievement.
Yeah, that's beautiful. I totally dig that. I do want to clarify though, just to make absolutely sure that everybody knows, like you do focus on AX combat and you put out a lot of amazing videos on the subject, but in addition to that, not so much Skunk Works, but you personally, Katie, under the channel of Commander Will and Kate, you and your husband, you put out amazing sort of videos on a broader spectrum of just all things sort of elite. And I've seen you put out stuff on like, hey man, here's our like take on patch 4 that we covered on last week's show, or here's our take on the plant gun, or you specifically were one of the people that like you got a hold of the on that day one, you know, cock up of Frontier, you got a hold of the plant exploration suit, and you got a hold of the plasma weapons, and you put out really great sort of sneak peek stuff. So not only, like, yes, absolutely, if you're interested in level AX play, check out Skunkworks, check out the videos of Commander Katie Burns, Commander Seraph, Commander Soldier Sailor, and all of the Skunkwork related crew. But it's not just AX stuff on your personal YouTube. You cover sort of a broader spectrum of all things that people might be interested in, even if AX isn't their thing.
Absolutely, yeah. When the alpha came out for Odyssey, we were covering the various phases of the alpha, and we still cover now the updates for alpha for Odyssey. Mm-hmm. We've actually got an event coming up that is exclusively Odyssey. I can't say too much about it, but yeah, we've got something coming up now that is exclusively Odyssey.
Nice.
But even prior to Odyssey, we were on the channel covering, for example, tutorials on how to begin in AX combat and how to engage Thargoids, mm-hmm. as well as ship reviews for anti-Xeno combat. But it isn't, as you say, it isn't just AX. There's coverage of Odyssey as well. Mm-hmm. And I hope to continue that in future.
That's beautiful. I love your channel. I will continue. I mean, yes, Skunkworks I love, but just me particularly, I love the Will and Kate channel for, like you said, the expanded Odyssey and all things sort of elite coverage. And I know for a fact that you've been getting into a little bit of Star Citizen. So we're going to talk about that on the Star Citizen section, because I definitely want your input on that. We also have Commander Seraph with us. Now, I want to say this because he's too polite. He's going to not want to really get into this. So I will say it bluntly. The billion-dollar plus company that is Frontier Developments, which is, in fact, the largest game development company in all of the UK, if you take all of their employees together and say, hey, give us a UI, give us some cool UI stuff, the process or the product that they will make after like 4 years of development is, nowhere near as good as the product that my man Commander Seraph would put out. So I'm going to go ahead and put on the screen. Now, the intro video that we had with the William Tell Overture, the 1812 Overture or whatever, that was legit good shit. But in addition to that, we also have, I want to put up here, asset 3 on the screen. Commander Seraph, now that I've introduced you, I've got your UI up on the screen. Can we take just a minute to have you walk us through, if you were in charge of doing the UI for Elite Dangerous and you were to say, hey, I want the like ship outfitting screen, how would you do it? It's up on the screen. Walk us through it.
Thank you, Kai, for your kind words. But I have to say I'm not the only one who'd come up with that. Most of the players of Elite Dangerous would probably come to conclusion that this is basically what we are looking for if you have more than 10 ships. What it is basically if you go to a shipyard, you want to know what is on your ship, not number of modules that are engineered or number of modules that have any that are Guardian, because that makes no sense and that's not something you would ever be interested in if you play the game like players do. But I will probably expand on that a little bit further in the show, because it's not an easy question of why the outfitting shipyard UI looks how it looks in Odyssey. We'll talk about that later if you don't mind.
Sure, no problem. So I'll pull that down. We can come back to it at another time. I just wanted to kind of take a look at it. But let's also sort of cover your, you have a YouTube channel, which is in the show notes as well, and you put out great stuff. And you are, in addition to being a commander that is one of the officers or one of the part of the leadership of Skunkworks, you are also a mentor at the AXI specifically. And so I want to give you a big salute for your 10K, you know, members on the Discord and the big event that you guys just did, the big hunt event. Why don't you tell us a little bit about your content, your channel, what you do with the AXI, what you do with the Skunkworks, anything you want to talk about?
Yeah, thank you. I am indeed a mentor at AXI. I'm not as active as I used to be because I basically have to, do stuff with Skunkworks, right? And I'm a staff member there. That's right. But thank you very much for your kind words again. We did hit 10,000 members recently, which is a big stunt. There is also an event going on right now, the Great Hunt. So you can, actually it's too late to join, but Axie is hosting a lot of stuff. Due to the fact that we hit that 10,000 members. Mm. I'll talk about what I do. I am a mentor, like you mentioned. I've been a member of AXI for over 2 years. I think over 2.5 years right now. At some point, me and Katie, we decided that we wanted to do a little bit more pro level AX, because as she mentioned, AXI is a great place to learn AX combat, but if you want to do something on high level in peace, mm-hmm. Ideally you would like to do it independently, where you can choose the people you want to do it with. That's how Skunkworks came to be.
Beautiful, beautiful. And again, your YouTube page is in the show notes for people to go check out. All three of these commanders in their own separate sort of way are just rock stars of the AX community. So if you are not subscribed to Katie Byrne or Seraph or Soldier Sailor, you're doing it wrong. Go check it out. And maybe it's something that appeals to you and maybe that it's not. I know kind of for a lot of people when they first start out, they look at AX stuff as like, oh, that's the other end of the spectrum. I'm not interested in that. I just kind of want to go and mine and go and explore and go and sort of do my easy level stuff. That's totally cool. Nobody's pushing you to do anything that you're not ready for. But know this, when you get to the point where you're like, hey, I now have, you know, my 10,000 hours in on Elite or my, you know, 2,000 or 3,000. And I feel like I'm ready to sort of stretch my wings and aim high. You definitely want to start with the AXI and learn all of the sort of fundamentals. Like going to the AXI is like going to basketball camp and like learning how to play. And you should do that. But watching the videos of Katie Byrne and Seraph and Soldier Sailor is kind of like watching, you know, Michael Jordan and Scottie Pippen play at the prime. And I think it's a beautiful thing and everybody should take a look at it. And that leads me right into Soldier Sailor. We got your Twitch channel in the Discord or in the show notes for everybody to see. You, my friend, there's definitely, you know, okay, you got the rock stars, you got the Malignos and the Gluttony Fang and your esteemed colleagues that are with us. But you personally are kind of what I ascribe to as you're the machine. You are the precision, like when I just see it, it's like, okay, this is how you do it if you had God mode of just like no missed shots, no, like every synth on time, everything. You are watching Michael Jordan play the way Shakespeare wrote it, my friend. So why don't you tell us a little bit about your channel and what you do?
Well, thank you for that kind introduction. I'll now have to try to never, ever miss a shot again in my whole life. So no pressure. But yeah, so I stream on Twitch a little less frequently these days just because of real life restraints. But I'm usually doing AX combat. I love helping new commanders get into AX because I'm really passionate about the sport. I really enjoy it. There's just nothing better. And like anybody can do it. You just have to learn the mechanics, practice. Yeah, I love the sport. And yeah.
Hell yeah. So everybody go, like I said, it'll be in the show notes. Check it out. Subscribe to these three. Look through the videos. You'll see what I'm saying. And I got to say this, Katie, specifically, I am baffled by the lack of Frontiers. Okay, I'm going to say this the right way. I'm baffled by their lack of reaching out to you. I have a link in the show notes to a specific video of yours. Soldier Sailor, Return to AX Conflicts, amazing video, great stuff. If you want to, like, really just, okay, I'm learning how to do this, I want to, you know, take it to the next level, that's there. But you, Katie, the Thargoid War episode 58, Victory in the Nebulous, that video, which just came out this week, that video in particular, to me, was more exciting than anything that I've seen Frontier put out in the last year, including Odyssey trailers. That, like the way that you hyped up the battle and, like, this is what's happened. We went to this system. We found this kind of resistance. We overcame it. Then we moved to this system where the fighting was even fiercer. Then we moved to this system. Like, holy shit. Watching that, honestly, the Thargoid War number 58, Victory in the Nebulous, to me, was better than any trailer I've seen come out of Frontier, like, going back to maybe the Horizons era. Like, going back for years. Like, it's in the show notes. Roy is linking it right now for the people that are watching live. I'm telling you right now, if you're watching this show live, click on it and then pause it, come back to us live as soon as the show ends, watch that fucking video, because it will blow your mind. Katie, has Frontier reached out to you at all about, like, hey, we want to hype this up on our news stream or our whatever, because, like, that is the best promotion of any whatever that I've seen in the longest time for this game.
First of all, I want to say thank you so much. That's an incredible compliment. I've not been contacted by Frontier. No. I do. We just love Thargoid Combat. We think that obviously the best part of the game for us is Thargoid Combat, but we also think that Frontier have done a fantastic job when it comes to balancing the mechanics of Thargoid Combat in a way that is, there are predictable rules to a Thargoid fight, but there's room for experimentation and room for you to add your own flair to it. And it's almost like, in my opinion, it's like the perfect gameplay in a lot of ways. Now, the barrier to entry, not even necessarily the skill barrier, but the material barrier to entry is something we can talk about later on. I would love for Frontier to contact me to voice some ideas to them, because they've hit a home run with Thargoid Combat. And I just feel like that the way that we fight Thargoids now is not the way they initially intended us to fight them. And if they would only, as you said, seeing footage of something exciting, like a battle against aliens, I mean, these are the parts of the game you want to see, right? These are the part, if I was not playing Elite and I could see someone grinding out materials or mining or something, or fighting a battle against aliens, I know which way I'd go with that. And I just think that because there's been some emergent techniques in the world of AX that have changed the way that Thargoids have fought since their inception, that there kind of needs to be a reevaluation on what is available to AX commanders in terms of mechanics and content that already exists in the game.
Mm.
Just making it more accessible to people. I think that's where the changes need to come.
100%, I agree. And we're going to get into that in the discussion topics a little bit, but I just have to say, regardless of what Frontier is getting right and what Frontier is getting wrong right now, the fact that they are not hyping the living fuck out of that particular video, that video to me, if I did not play this game and had no clue about it and just saw that video, I literally, that's like the part from Starship Troopers where they're like, do you want to know more? And it's like, I'm doing my part. That you in particular have a gift. You and honestly, for my money, and I'm sure there are others, and I apologize now for the people that I'm leaving out, but you and Avasu have a particular gift for putting out sort of propaganda videos of like, fight for the motherland, let's kick some ass, that like that to me, if I did not own this game and I saw that video, I'd be like, I need to buy that game and get into that war. So I just want to give you a big huge salute for that. Much love.
And also, can I just add really quickly, you just mentioned Avasa there. Avasa, make the AXI debrief again. It was awesome. We all used to love watching. Honestly, it was my favorite thing to watch.
Oh, yes. I love and miss Avasa. I want to have Avasa's babies. He's fucking just legit. He's just legit. He's just one of my favorite people. So, yes, we miss you.